Hello, welcome to the channel. I would like to share with you an exciting news. Yuzu, in its latest version, 3524, underwent an update that can revolutionize the gaming experience for players with more modest computers. The update included a rewrite of the buffer cache, which means that users who use the GPU in normal mode can expect a significant performance gain. In fact, some users reported an absurd increase in performance. This is part of the YFC project, which promises to further improve the performance of Yuzu. When fully implemented, we can expect an even greater gain. To test this update, we will compare the performance of some games before and after the update. Let's find out together what the real performance gain is. And before we start, we'd like to ask for your help. If you're enjoying this type of content, please leave a like to help us spread the word. Also, if you enjoy news and emulator comparisons, don't forget to subscribe to our channel to receive new videos every week.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
To start the tests, I would like to share the settings that will be used during the tests. The emulators will be run at native resolution, with FSR enabled and without any type of anti-aliasing. For those who wish to delve deeper into the settings used, I will leave the complete list in the video description. The tests will be conducted using version 3520 of the Yuzu emulator, which was the version I used before the update, and the latest version at the time of recording this video, which is version 3531. Let's now move on to the tests and see how these different versions compare in terms of performance in selected games. Let's start our test with one of the most challenging games to emulate on Yuzu, Astral Chain. I decided not to use the 60fps mod to ensure more accurate results, and all tests will be conducted with unlocked FPS. Unfortunately, in Astral Chain, no noticeable performance gain was observed with the update. It's important to remember, however, that some games may have temporary performance regression but will be fixed in the future. Next, we have the game Fire Emblem Three Houses, which is locked at 60fps and cannot be unlocked without using mods. During our comparative tests, we observed that at some moments there is a reduction of up to 20% in GPU usage, which represents a significant improvement in game optimization. Considering that this is an update, this is a great result, don't you agree? Now, let's talk about one of the games that had a big impact with the update, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. During the tests we conducted, we noticed a performance increase in some moments of up to 30 to 40%. In addition, the new version also fixes lighting bugs, which can be observed in the game, as the lighting on the track looks much more natural and realistic than before. Now, a big surprise and at the same time sadness was the performance of the game Pokémon Scarlet. In the previous version, the game was full of vertex explosions and could barely maintain 20 FPS, but in the new version it is running above 30 FPS easily. Although the improvement was welcome, it was a sadness for me because I had already recorded a video comparing which emulator would be the better one to play the new Pokémon, which was already available to YouTube members and Patreons. Due to this update, I had to redo the video. If you are a Pokémon fan like me, you now have two options to play this wonderful game. Now, another game from the Pokémon franchise that had many improvements is Pokémon Sword. Although we still don't know if the numerous random crashes have been fixed, the experience of playing the game has become much smoother, with a performance increase of almost 50%. Recently, I did a comparison of the game Smash Bros. Ultimate, which could barely maintain 60 frames per second with 8 CPU-controlled players. Although the previous version had already solved this problem, managing to maintain a rate of over 70 FPS, the new update provided an additional performance gain, with an average between 70 to 80 FPS. As for the increased RAM usage with the new version, this should not be a big problem, as after playing a match or two, the memory consumption returns to normal. Super Mario Odyssey is undoubtedly one of the best games on the Switch and a must-play experience for everyone who has the emulator. With the new update, we can clearly see the improvement made in lighting, which was previously a problem in several games and hurt the overall experience. Additionally, there has been a performance gain of up to 30%, making gameplay even more enjoyable. If you haven't updated yet, this is a great reason to do so. Finally, The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild is certainly one of the main contributors to the performance improvements in the Yuzu emulator. The development team knows that Tears of the Kingdom will use the same engine as Breath of the Wild, so they are preparing to ensure that the game runs smoothly on launch day. This could further increase the relevance of the emulator in the gaming scene. Regarding performance, there has been a significant increase of almost 50% in the average FPS of the new version compared to the previous one, as well as corrections to lighting and shadow effects and other minor improvements. Remember that not long ago, we published a video on our channel about which is the best emulator to play Zelda Breath of the Wild. And what about you? Do you think your PC is ready to run Tears of the Kingdom on Yuzu? In summary, the new update for the Yuzu emulator brings significant performance improvements and bug fixes for several popular Nintendo Switch games, making the experience of playing on the emulator even closer to the original. And with the expectation that Tears of the Kingdom, which will use the same engine as Breath of the Wild, can run on the emulator right at launch, Yuzu remains an increasingly attractive option for fans of Nintendo Switch games who want to play on PC. I hope this video was helpful for you and see you next time.